Well, first of all, it's obvious you're in Washington, D.C. You're out there for an RNC, a Republican National Committee meeting. What is it that you're working on, and has the subject of Michigan's primary come up?
Well, it has. I mean, the major issue this week was we were going over the Rules Committee proposals for the 2012 presidential primary. We're basically taking a look at how we're going to change the rules, what we're going to do to affect the next process. And the Republicans, unlike the Democrats, actually pass their rules 4 years in advance so that everybody knows what the rules are, and then we live by them. So what I did is I presented the plan that Debbie Dingell and I put together. I presented it to the Republicans. She's going to be presenting it to the Democrats. And we're one of five different plans that are being considered that will be actually voted on in our April meeting coming up this spring.
Has there been any conversation about seating of Republicans? Delegates. Democrats, of course, have threatened to take away all the delegates. Republicans have threatened to take away at least half of the delegates. Is this something that's going to be resolved in this meeting, or will that come later if it is to happen?
Yeah, it'll come later. Right now, the rules are very clear that we will lose half of our delegates. That's the intent of the Republican National Committee, is to abide by those rules. But as we've talked about in the past, what we've basically done is that the intention of all the states who have gone early in consultation with the various presidential campaigns is that we'll be taking full delegations to the Credentials and Rules Committee at the National Convention in Minneapolis. And then what they'll have to do is suspend the rules on the floor of the convention to allow full delegations to be seated. So the issue of whether or not we get 30 or 60 delegates will be taken care of at the actual convention in Minneapolis over Labor Day.
As you talk about the rules for 2012, is there any consideration of changing this whole lineup so Iowa and New Hampshire don't go first, a lottery, regional, something?
There is. Basically, there are five different proposals. Four of them are regional types. One of them is just a rotation. The plan that Debbie Dingell and I put together basically sets up six regions in the country, six sub-regions within each region in the country, to basically make sure that you would have a representative vote from around the country at six different elections starting in March and ending in June. So the idea would be, you know, like Northeast might take Vermont, the South might take South Carolina. You might get Texas, you might get Oregon, and Ohio out of the Midwest, an example. And that would go on the second Tuesday in March. 4 weeks later, you have a second round, 4 weeks later, a third round, et cetera, through six rounds.
Let's talk a little bit about the primary that just passed. Obviously, Democrats didn't have a lot of participation. Republicans had somewhat better, but there were still big names. Giuliani, Thompson, who decided not to play here in Michigan. How satisfied are you that moving the primary forward was a good idea and got Michigan the kind of attention that you would express you would like to have?
Well, from a Republican standpoint, we were very happy. Obviously, look, for the last almost 2 years now, Republican candidates have been coming to Michigan. They've set up campaign organizations. They participated, you know, in our last two Mackinac Island conferences. Many local Republicans, Kent County, Ottawa County, all over the state, had Republicans come and speak to the Lincoln Day dinners, to their various party events. So we really had a tremendous amount of attention paid to Michigan Republicans based on the fact that we had moved our primary up. B, we also were able to host a presidential debate on the Republican side, which was a unique thing for Michigan. And a big opportunity to start talking about issues facing Michigan. And then see, if you take a look at the last week, really, we started talking about jobs and the economy. I think we were actually successful in changing the debate throughout the whole country, as now all these candidates are taking a look at the successes the candidates had addressing those issues to the voters of Michigan, why they were relevant. And look, with a national recession potentially challenging us, it is becoming a more relevant issue. And the things that affected us in Michigan are starting to worry the people in the rest of the country.
How dangerous is it for Republican candidates to talk about the economy? After all, Republicans have been in charge for a good deal of these last 7 years with both the House, the Senate, and the White House. Obviously, Democrats took over in last November, a couple of months ago. But Republicans have a certain amount of responsibility for this economy,
sure,
don't they?
Well, first of all, look, what we're talking about is the fiscal policy that will affect the economy. I mean, the bottom line is the economy has grown. We've created millions of new jobs nationwide under President Bush's leadership and the tax cuts that were passed. Now, if we can make these tax cuts permanent and make sure that the American people keep more of the money in their pockets, I think you're going to see a much greater success ratio. And that's why it's important for Republicans to be talking about this. We have to let them know that there's going to be a difference between what Senator Clinton is proposing proposing, what Senator Barack Obama are proposing, versus what any of our candidates are. And tax cuts stimulate the economy. Having sound tax policy, fair international trade, will stimulate the economy. Making sure currency manipulation doesn't take place will, again, help our domestic auto industry compete nationwide. So Republicans have a lot to talk about, and it's very relevant because we're really talking about choosing two different directions, one proposed by the Democrats and one proposed by the Republicans.
Talk to me about Michigan in November. We have always been a hotly contested state. Republicans haven't won the state in a general election for 20 years. As you come back into this state, if you end up with a Rudy Giuliani, for example, I take that because he hasn't been here as much as some of the other candidates, or if you end up with a Mitt Romney who did well here in the primary, how confident are you that Republicans will have a chance here that they haven't had in the last three or four election cycles?
Well, I think we'll probably have the best chance we've had in a very long time. I mean, a couple different things have changed. First of all, the way you win in Michigan is you have to get your fair share of independent votes. You know, the candidates on the Republican side, particularly the Mitt Romneys and the John McCains and others, have been campaigning in Michigan on a very consistent, regular basis over the last 2 years. And I think they've been selling their message, kind of giving their message to the people of Michigan. So if you're an independent voter or even a swing Democrat or a Reagan Democrat type of voter, you've had a chance to meet these Republican candidates. Well, the Democrats have literally boycotted our state. They've stayed away from our state by design to concentrate in New Hampshire and Iowa. That's going to give us a competitive advantage because a lot of voters want to meet the candidates. They want to hear what they have to say. And I think many people in Michigan will get a feeling that they know the Republicans a lot better than they'll get to know the Democrats. And I think the message will also resonate to the people of Michigan. So I think this is going to be a unique opportunity for us in Michigan. I think the Republicans are going to be kind of on the offense this time around. And the Democrats have a lot of ground to make up. It will continue to be a tight state and a close race, but I think Michigan Republicans and the Republicans in Michigan will have a great opportunity to maybe take this one for the president.
By the time this airs, we will already have some results from some of the other states, but when you go through Florida and then on to Super Tuesday, is it possible, even likely, that Republicans are going to have four or five primary winners as you move into Super Tuesday, and Super Tuesday is going to be really a wide open battle for this nomination?
Well, it's very possible. I mean, the reality is that Republicans have a wide choice of great candidates that are winning in different states based on different strategies, geographical advantages, and the makeup of those states. And I think it's very possible that we're going to come in a Super Tuesday, which is very unheard of in from recent history, that we're going to have 22 states voting for the first time with no front runner and no, you know, challenger. And so we're going to have four or five candidates who will have emerged from the early seven, eight states and going into Super Tuesday, where the people of America, really across the board, we'll have to take a look at these Republican candidates and we'll see who emerges. I think the likelihood is we're going to have at least a leader emerge on Super Tuesday and a leading challenger emerge on Super Tuesday. But clearly, Rick, I think you're right. The possibility is there that this could be a wide open ballgame and we could emerge with three or four potential candidates that are still viable.
I got about 30 seconds left. As it pertains to the race for the Republican nomination, is Michigan's vote significant?
Absolutely. It's going to be critical. The Democrats cannot win the White House without winning Michigan. Now, they haven't done that since, I think, Jimmy Carter, and that was an anomaly. If you take a look at it overall, Michigan is a swing state. It's a bellwether state. It's very important with respect to where Reagan Democrats and independents come through, and this is going to be a very, very tight race all the way to the wire.
Saul Anuzis, chairman of the Republican Party here in the state of Michigan in Washington for an RNC meeting. Thank you for taking time to talk to us.
Thanks for having me.